Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, you know her very well by this time. I have been starting and you are learning the Duchess of Malfi, written by John Webster. Lesson number 2, and you know very well, and you know to me, this is very important for you. Okay, I like to go to start. Number 1, introduction to the Duchess of Malfi. Introduction to the Duchess of Malfi. Tamanna, please. Video, tomorrow, the background is not suitable.
Yes, background. Sir.
Come on, Jannatul Firdaus. I don't know where is you. Your background is not suitable. Please. I like to omit it.
Hey, come on, network.
I like to omit it. This is not clear. Your background is not suitable.
Still,
not fresh. Still. Outer background has coming. Outer background is coming. Outer null.
Sir, wait, wait.
Non external. Okay.
Yes, sir.
You can off your video. You can off your video. And another will come here. Another will come here. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Introduction to the Duchess of Malfi. You cannot use video. So that's the problem. You cannot use video. Okay, everybody except Sarna, please. Everybody come here. Open your video. Open your video. Number 1, stage history of the play. Stage history of the play. You know very well, there is no direct documentary evidence. Documentary record to identify the written time of the Duchess of Malfi, a revenge tragedy written by John Webster. So when it was written, it was totally unknown to everybody. But some critics conclude that the play must have written or have been written between the time 1612 to 1614. But some internal evidence shows that it should have been written after the White Devil. You know, it was also written by John Webster. Maybe the composition date is between 1610 to 1612. So a lot of confusions are there about the written and published date. Okay. Number 2, some of the source of the story. What are the source of the story? The story of the Duchess of Malfi can be traced to Nabil. 1554 of the Italian author Matteo Bandiolo. You know, normally the Italian people's at the end of the letter of the people's name is normally O. So Matteo Bandiolo. It was freely adopted into the French. First of all, it was translated into French, that is France, by Belley Forest in 1565 under the title History's Tragedy. It is important. Under the title, you see here, History's Tragedy. William Painter, another writer, adapted the French stories into England. So it was, or it has come to England, first of all, it was introduced, or it has come into France in French language, then it has come into in England in English language. Under the title Palace of Pleasure, which was written in 1667. So it is the source of the story. Source means from where the theme or the materials had been taken by the dramatist John Webster. Okay, so we can say it was first come from Italy, and next France, or France, next in England, and written in English language. Okay. Number three, original stone. So what is the original stone? From where and what type of a stone was? The historical duchess was married in 1490. You see here, this is my cursor. I like to use 1400. I like to want what type of it is. Yes, yes, yes. Now it is very, 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 very elaborately. I like to see to show you the original duchess was married in 1490 at the age of 12. So first of all, you should know duchess, a lady, a princess. When she was only 12 years old, she was married. But unfortunately, her husband died when she was 20. So 8 years their couple life had gone. So when she was 20 years old, her husband died. Normally, finding no other alternative, she fell in love with Antonio Blogan, one of the employees of the palace, and married him secretly. This is important. When she was 20 years old, her husband died, and normally she fell in love with a steward of the palace, with one of the employees of the palace. But the employee is lower class people or a man. And not only this, they married secretly. Only witness is waiting maid. One of the maids of the palace is the witness. But the marriage remained secret until a child was born to them. So nobody can, or nobody knew this incident or this marriage. But when the first child was born, up to that, nobody knew this. With the birth of a second child, rumors began to spread. But when she had given birth second child, some people of the palace knew it. Her two brothers, Cardinal Lodovico, Cardinal, just you should remember Cardinal, and Carlo, two names. So you can imagine, or you can identify three legal members of the palace. Number one, Cardinal. Number two, Carlo, two brothers, and a daughter, Duchess. Only three members, legal members of the palace. And Carlo engaged spies to watch her. So when the rumor was running out in the war, the people of the palace were gossiping about the birth of the second child, Cardinal and Carlo, two brothers, engaged spies to watch her. Among them, among the spies, main spy was Bozzola, the criminal. Bozzola, the criminal. So, during the time when it was going to be spread, Antonio went away to Ancona. You see here, Antonio, her husband, second husband, went away to Ancona, a place of Italy, a town of Italy, with the two children. With the two children, Antonio left the palace and secretly went to Ancona. The duchess at that time was pregnant with a third child. So she is going to birth another child called third child. Later she also went to Impona. But the next time, Duchess was also sent or went to Impona to her second husband and her children under the pretext of a pilgrimage to nearby Loreto. So first of all, Duchess went to Loreto, another sort of small town, a small town, under the pretext of pilgrims, a team, a religious people's team. With them, she went to Loreto. At Ancona, when she reached Ancona, she revealed her marriage to the family. She introduced and she told the real incidents to the family. So the cardinal had her and the two children banished first from Ancona. So the cardinal, his brother, first of all, he sent or banished, he exiled Nirbhashito Kora. He exiled or banished first from Ancona and next from Sen. Later, she and her two youngest children and her waiting woman was killed already. Two sons were killed, and the only witness, the waiting woman, was killed. Antonio fled to Milan. You know Milan, one of the most important town of Italy, Milan. Antonio fled to Milan, but he was killed by Daniel di Bologna. Just, it is very brief answer. The main criminal of the day. So on the way, Antonio was killed by the criminal or one of the most important spy in this play, Daniel di Bozzola, full name. But actually, Bozzola is very common name, popular name. Okay, thank you, dear. Next, number four. Number four, characters are made more vivid. All the characters are here very nicely and successfully established and set up in the plot construction of the play. Webster actually developed the character, mainly the Duchess, into a person of gracious spirit. The Duchess became a very strong character in this play. Her passionate attachment to her second husband. You know, first husband already died. Second husband, Antonio, and their children are already delicately portrayed. So in this play, when you study seriously or go through the drama seriously, you see the character of Bozzola, a criminal character, and the Duchess, the princess of the palace, real character, passionate character, sympathetic character, very strong character, popular character. But it is done by Mr. John Webster, the dramatist of Jacobean time, Elizabethan and Jacobean time. So the portrayal, the character of Duchess is really a very appreciable character. The dramatist makes the cardinal and the duke appear more convincing. The dramatist here very nicely, presented all characters. The two brothers are also effectively disguised. Okay, thank you, dears. We can go the next. Five, the Duchess of Malfi as a revenge play. Very important. You should have to get by heart. You should go through the This is one of the most important question. But I like to hear present very little. Seneca, you know, one of the most important dramatists in the history of drama in English literature, Seneca. Seneca had established the tradition in the first century Italy. He wrote a lot of dramas, and all dramas are revenge play. For this reason, Seneca is called a revenge dramatist. Seneca mainly established the tradition, this tradition, the revenge tradition, in the first century Italy, in Italy. The Italian tradition reached England along with other Renaissance of ideas. Thomas Kidd, a most important English dramatist, Thomas Kidd, wrote his the most important revenge play, the Spanish tragedy. You see here the Spanish tragedy. It was written by Thomas Kidd, who was born in England, very famous dramatist in the contemporary time. So the Spanish tragedy was written by Thomas Kidd under the Senecan influence, because he took all the elements, all the themes from the Seneca of Italy. Webster chose to write the play in the Elizabethan tradition of a revenge play. But Webster tried to write or to present the play as a revenge play, but in Elizabethan tradition. Thomas Kidd directly used the Senecan tradition, but our writer John Webster, he tried to write the play Elizabethan tradition of a revenge play. The best of Webster, you know, Webster is a famous writer, famous dramatist, and among them, of the dramas, the best of Webster, The White Devil, you know, The White Devil is his first drama, and The Duchess of Malfi, both are revenge tragedy, but it was written according to the theory of that, or the tradition of the English tradition or Elizabethan tradition, Jacobean tradition. Both are attempts in revenge tradition. So both the plays are in follows the Elizabethan or Jacobean tradition. This new twist has given to the revenge tragedy, and the dramatist John Webster shows an originality in this. So the Duchess of Malfi actually is a great play, is a revenge play, and he, the writer, John Webster, tried to show the revenge elements, but he follows the Elizabethan or Jacobean tradition. Okay, next. Thank you, dears. Next, we like to go six number. The art of characterization, very important. Because every writer or every dramatist, please open your video, who are here. Please open your video, Shruti 17. Shruti 17, now you admit here. 17, I request all my students, please. Just time. You should use your time properly. Just time, you should have to admit in my class.
Sir, time is over.
No. 40 minutes. 40 minutes. Oh, yes.
Sir, this is the last time.
This is the last one. So, Webster advanced over contemporary playwrights in the art of characterization. His skill delineating realistic characters and making them convincing is simply clear. The Duchess of Malfi. The central figure the Duchess faces her misfortune with a stoic fortitude and calm resignation. The Cardinal, the Duke, and Bajola are the Machiavellian characters. The Duchess, though innocent, has some flaw. She is one of the most delicately portrayed woman characters in the history of drama, like Desdemona of Shakespeare, the world famous dramatist in the history of English. So thank you, dears. I like to not request order while my students please come or admit or enter into my class proper time. And you know very well your roll number will be counted. You have seen here, or you see here, it will be counted. And I like to request Tamanna, please, by name and role, please send me. Okay, thank you. Well, the next time I will start from 7. Okay, introduction. Thank you, dears. Study.
Okay, sir.
Okay, Allah Hafiz.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, rahmatullahi.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.